Hello, beautiful people. I'm back again. This is Sudhama, your communication coach, with my Be Spoken and Be Heard's pep talk. Yes, today, as I promised, I'll be coming up with yet another interesting and amazing academician. Well, he is an academician and also a founder director of a very important educational organization in the district of Anantapur. Well, he is a founder director of Afflatus Global School, Anantapur District. He, before venturing into founding or setting up his school, he has also been a trained teacher, worked as a government teacher, and also worked as a zoology faculty for medical entrance coaching. He has done quite a remarkable innovative initiatives for the student communities in the district of Anantapur. And also he is a former student of the prestigious school, Andhra Pradesh Residential Schools, and he's here with us, Mr. Solomon Raj. Solomon, sir, welcome to Pep Talk.
Thank you, Sudha. Thank you very much. Hi, all.
And people who are watching us, probably your alumni must be watching you today.
Yes.
They're all here to know more about you. Probably they might have missed seeing you during this lockdown. So hopefully through Pep Talk, they'll be knowing you more.
Yeah, sure, sure.
So you've been a teacher, a government teacher. Then now you are currently a director for your own school. So how did this journey started?
Before going to the actual this thing, I'd like to share a few lines.
Sure, sir.
An introductory one, right?
Sure.
I was born and brought up in a rural village in Anantapur district. And
right.
My father was a teacher.
Okay. Right?
In fact, he was my first teacher.
Wow.
So we were in a small village. So I studied in Telugu medium till my 10th grade. Okay. So after that, in grade 8, I went to the prestigious, as you mentioned, AP Residential School, Kodiginahalli.
Right.
There were only three schools then in entire this thing. So that was the most luckiest phase of my life, to have spent my time in such a prestigious school. So from there, generally people will dream of becoming an IAS officer, IPS officer, or
right.
Good famous doctors. We have scientists, so many people.
Right.
I missed the train in the first phase.
Right.
So then eventually life took me to a teaching profession in the government sector. After getting into the government profession, I realized what actually my potential is.
Okay.
So for the last 10 years, I was, a very fun guy and never cared about career and all.
Okay.
So I just, once I landed up in the small village preschool where I was given task of teaching grade 1 children, it was one way, it was shocking, the other way. So that incident made me think, and I realized myself, no, this is not the right place for me. I don't say that is not the right place or right profession. It is the right profession.
Okay.
As far as I am concerned, I may be the wrong person there. So I thought I am the wrong person there. Then I thought for a couple of months, and finally I discussed with my wife. And she said, okay, then I left it.
Okay.
So directly I resigned the job, and then I went to Hyderabad where I taught, all that.
Yes. You're
so right. then generally we change place or career.
Right.
With two or more objectives.
True.
One being your job satisfaction.
Right.
Second one being the passion we carry for that.
True.
Third one, of course, it depends on the person, the priority. The third priority for me was money.
Financial, right.
So then I went to a corporate institute where I taught for medical coaching. I got, there also I was not happy. To be frank, yes.
Okay.
There also I was not happy because I was happy with the children.
Okay.
Because it is always a professional coaching means only few people, students can stand up to that level. Remaining students, they are lost. we can't justify them because it's not your institute, right? We need to follow the rules and regulations of the organization setup. So they're also still slowly developed dissatisfaction.
Right.
Then it made me to attend an interview to US. I got selected as a teacher in Atlanta.
Wow.
I even got H-1B also. And then I thought, so by then I was 30 plus. Then I thought, so in those 10 years of journey, I noticed student was struggling.
Right.
Teacher is struggling. Parents are struggling. And the management is also struggling. No one is happy in the system.
True.
There every day I used to recollect my experiences in my school.
Okay.
Where students were very, very happy.
Right.
Students studied all the subjects. Students played all the games. There were singers at state level. There were sprinters at state level. One of my classmates by name Sridhar, he is a state second ranker then, my badge.
Okay.
And he is state first in running, 100 meter dash.
Right.
So why I'm telling this is, in that particular school, we missed nothing, absolutely nothing.
Right.
And even in every area, we had perfection. The beauty is that.
Right.
And teacher was very happy.
Right.
Second. Right. And of course, parents.
Yeah.
Parents were very, very happy parents.
Right.
And of course, government is the management. Government is also happy with policy. So that made me think for many hours, days and days. Finally, an idea is conceptualized. I conceived an idea. Why can't we do that?
Uh-huh.
With the modern demands.
Okay.
The use of technology. So on par with the present day technological applications, taking the old Gurukula philosophy,
right.
We blended the concept, and that's how I came into this particular stage and establishing a school.
Right.
And I'm really happy, Sudhav, for this because I'm very, very happy. This is the 8th year of my operations here.
Okay.
As principal, as the director of academics, as far as school is concerned, right? In you know, the general perception of a parent in AP,
right.
They're always after IIT, JEE or NEET.
Right.
We are not like that.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And for your understanding, I'll tell you one simple thing. We have 10 physical education teachers, each coach for each kid. So that is how focusing the all-round development of the child,
right.
With the help of technology.
Right.
I've started my school with my friends. There are five of my friends with me.
Okay.
I'm thankful to them for their kind support and all. So that's how we are able to create a trend in this particular district. I don't say larger scale. As far as this is concerned, we started it. Luckily, few other people started following the trend.
Right.
There, and our philosophy is reaching thousands of children. Thousands of children are now happy in this district. So thank God for this wonderful opportunity, and all the parents who supporting this. So this is how it happened.
Started. Yeah. So all that starts well ends well. So you're a contented man. You happy, the society is happy, children are happy. So what more do we want as educators? And the overall approach you wanted to do that made you happy, overall your milestones. You started on a dissatisfactory note and now you're a happy man. So you definitely have to speak because you are mentioning about your school that influenced you, that evolved you as an individual.
Sure.
So, and talk about your alma mater, this APRS schools.
So it started in 1972 by the then Chief Minister of AP, P.V. Narasimha Rao.
Right.
I think he was the education minister then, I'm sorry.
Okay.
So the three schools started then, one in Telangana for 9 district, Sarveli, which is nearby Hyderabad. The other one for Rayalaseema and Nellore, 5 districts, Kodaikanal Residential School. The other one is in Tadikonda, nearby Guntur, covering the five coastal districts. So okay. So students, it was very difficult to get a seat here.
Is it?
And you asked me what any awards, rewards and all.
Right.
The best award, the best reward, whatever I get in future also,
right.
The best one would be Miss getting a seat in that particular school.
Oh, qualifying screening award,
yeah,
screening sessions.
It was such a difficult exam those days.
Okay.
So then after that school, actually, it's a holistic school where every sphere of the child is nurtured and developed.
Right.
Everything. And they'll the system, without our knowledge, takes out what all potentials we have, the child have.
Wow.
Without your knowledge, your singing capacity will come out in a few days after joining them.
Okay.
An athlete will come out of you. So right. It's total transformation of personality. And also, one such beauty thing is, everyone has got love for society.
Oh.
End of the day, we need to have love and ethics, right? Ethics and values.
Right, right.
So that particular school, we always loved society. That's the reason why we spend a lot of money for the school. Recently, we have spent 2 crore rupees for the development of the school, for the infrastructure.
Right.
So giving back to society then.
Right.
So it teaches values, teaches subjects. And on top of it, I'll tell you one point. My school taught me how to learn.
Wow.
Anything. Okay. Maybe mathematics, it may be science, it may be English, it may be a general talk, it may be any subject or anything. So we learn things the way they should be learned, I can
right.
tell you. On our own. That's a beauty of learning. And same point I am taking here also. We are
right.
enabling students to learn on their own.
Right.
And that my particular school, we have nearly 50 civil servants, like IAS, IPS.
Yes.
And IRS officers.
Right. All top notch bureaucrats.
Top. Right. I batch, I have 2 civil servants.
Right.
Doctors, hundreds of engineers, those businessmen.
Right.
And there are vice presidents, presidents of leading software institutes. So that school, so that is the greatness of this school. And the other aspect is we value human relations.
Right.
That's the best part of learning we learned from our school. So I'm very much thankful to the school and the government. I'm proud to be a student of APR school, Kodinahalli. And we will continuously serve the school and the poor children. The beauty is all are poor children.
Okay.
Whoever studies there, they'll come up with
they'll definitely become someone. Not just be left out, I guess.
Of course. And all their poor children and rural children. So we are continuously helping them in reaching out their goals.
Right.
So that's about the alma mater.
So did this school, I guess your school has germinated. I mean, that was where the seeds are being sowed into you to become a community builder, like being associated with Jeevani Foundation.
Yes.
Right, and different other philanthropic activities, I guess. Right. How about the activities that you mentioned that you're part of and your school could make to the President's Award under Swachh Bharat? Would you love to talk on that?
Yeah, that's what I'm telling you. So it was in 2014-15.
Right.
I'll take some time.
Sure, sir.
It is inspirational because I should thank those people also.
Sure,
one of my seniors came as a superintendent of police to Anantapur district, SP,
right.
IPS officer, by name Rajshekhar Babu. Okay. Now he is DIG in Amravati.
Okay.
He is my senior. So one day he called me and asked, Salman, how is school? So actually, I didn't go to my school last 3 years or so. I told him, Then he said, go and watch. So I went there. I found a boy in a sixth class dormitory straight away walked without any information. One boy was lying on the floor with all scabies on his skin. I asked him, since 30 days that fellow was sleeping, I mean, spending his time in the dormitory. Okay. And I literally, tears rolled down my cheeks and called him. Situation is very pathetic. Anna, we have to do something. Then on war footing basis, we have changed the floorings, okay. We changed the roofs. We gave cots to all the children. Cots. We gave a steam cooking unit to the school.
Okay.
Yeah, which is worth of 25 lakhs. Okay. Totally, it's more than a corporate school in Anandapur now. We gave all the gaming facility. We have changed the total laboratory.
Right.
Every batch adopted one mark.
Wow.
So altogether, we have done a digital laboratory, which is worth 25 lakhs. So like, the nearly 2 crore worth work was done in a span of 1.5 years.
Right.
The then collector, Sri Kona Sisdar,
right.
Whose children were studying in my school, Aphrodite Global School.
Okay.
That town is a little close to me, and SP sir was also close to that gentleman.
Right.
We invited him on one occasion. After roaming entire school, yeah. After watching it, he was impressed, and we never asked him for any help. He himself voluntarily gave 10 lakh rupees to the development of the school. So with that inspiration, every batch took up some or the other work. Every batch. So entire, someone toilet, someone a solar water heaters, every facility is facilitated. And the school was like, you know, it's a very, very
clean. It got a complete makeover.
Makeover. And advantage for the school is, as it is the oldest school,
okay,
they have that very, very huge greenery, big trees, right. We have. And that made the school to bag Swachh Bharat Award. So special thanks to my alumni, because I took up it, I led the team here as a volunteer. A special thanks to the collector, Kona Shishthir sir, and ASP senior, Ashwekar Anna, and all other seniors, APRS school, alumni, US chapter and Indian chapter. There are 2 chapters.
Okay.
Everyone donated. And now also we are taking care of it.
Right.
Still now, it's going on.
So, it has to be like, you people learn something and you're giving back voluntarily. Nothing been asked. Everybody are just putting something back to their, the place, the bed of learning, I guess.
Yes.
Right. Awesome, beautiful. So now talking about, you've been talking about so much about your schooling, your school, and then here comes to about your own school, one which you founder, is a founder. And what are the initiatives that you have replicated? That was your model school which you studied. You might have replicated some of its initiatives, some of its ideologies in your Aphrodite Global School. So what are those initiatives?
Sudha, as such, we cannot replicate anything.
Right.
The thing is, because generation has changed.
True.
Parent thinking has changed and market demands have changed. The last 3 decades, there has been a tremendous change in the education system.
Right.
Education system. So, the beauty of the school which I studied is, it helped us to learn on our own, as I already told.
Right.
And it made us realize that we can do anything. And if you're not exaggerating, I tell you, we always feel, if not we, who can?
Yes, so true.
But don't take me other way, but we always feel like, if some quality work is being done by some others, we generally feel so jealous of it.
So persist with your school.
Yeah. So that's what I tell you. Whenever I go to school, I tell the students only one thing. I tell that school, you're all special. You're all special. So study well, reach high. So that particular philosophy I got.
Mm-hmm.
So to make the student elevate his thinking to maximum up to his potentials, that is one thing. And the second thing is, as I told you, that we have changed the philosophy according to the present day demands and all. Likewise, we have developed new tools. As I told you, activity-based comprehensive conceptual learning, which is a new. There is activity-based learning. There is also. Where it is designed to transfer the concept from the teacher to the student. Whenever you talk about concept, it is only to the, what I can say is, concept is related to only one subject. So we have developed comprehensive concept where in understanding one particular concept, you need to have knowledge of concepts in the other related subjects. In understanding biology, you need to apply concept of chemistry, concept of physics, concept of mathematics. So if a teacher can touch all these things, if a teacher, first of all, teacher need to have knowledge in the collateral concepts from the other subject, then this conceptual learning will be very, very effective. Teach and leave. No need of assignments, no need of homeworks. So that is one thing. That is the methodology we have developed. And other new things like SOC school clubs, as I told you. So SOC school means society. The major drawback in my school was we were never exposed to the society. We were in school. Everything was fine. So whenever we were allowed to play our role in the society, we were actually failures. I tell you, there are no good leaders from our school.
So you're indirectly making a point that leaders haven't been, there are no leaders.
Social leaders, I'm sorry. There are leaders in professions. There are big people. Socially, there are no leaders. So directly I tell you, there is no politician from my school. Then who is at the top of the hierarchy in the administration? A politician is at the top of the hierarchy. So we realize now, and we are telling the students to get into politics. With social responsibility.
True.
So keeping that in mind, because we need to see ourselves in the society. There are different roles in the society. Where to which position I am perfectly suitable. When you don't have a chance to look at the different options, you'll have to go with whatever you get. Keeping this in mind, the introduced SOC schooling clubs, where SOC stands for school. Society, school is good. So where we bring in professional from society to school. In the school, the children are divided into clubs like technical club, medical club, civil servants, political people, teachers, based on their interest, irrespective of the class. Particularly from high school children. So we get the professional from outside, from the society to the school, we make them to interact with that particular gentleman. And as a second attempt, the same group is taken to the society, that gentleman. These people will see that gentleman in his office. What is he doing? What is the scope of work he can do? There also there will be an interactive session. So these are all literally difficult, but we're continuously doing, and after a period of time, they are bringing in a lot of changes among the children. And that will have you need not tell anyone to become an IAS officer or to become a doctor or something else like that.
They're all sorted out, I guess, with such exposure.
Let them see the entire society at the early stages itself. Let them fix goal at the age of 8th or 9th. So that without any wastage of time, they'll reach the goal. So that is the that's another product which we have designed. And it's not, they're all not new, Sudha. It's,
right.
Once again, I tell you, I humbly tell you, these are all with the consent for children we are doing. And in future also, we may come up with different approaches and tools, right? Because we love children, we know their needs and necessities, and we will always try to fulfill the same. That's how these products have come in. And this year, recently, we have introduced Idea Club.
Idea Clubs.
Yeah. Aflatin Idea Club. The background is, for everything, there is a background.
Okay.
Every day, we do science fairs at school level, district level, okay, state level. What generally they do is, a topic is given to the all students.
Okay.
They'll prepare. They'll prepare a model and they'll do charts and all. There is a place where they'll showcase their activities. A group of judges will come and go. This has become practice where every item is available in the market.
Okay.
Once the title of the science fair is released, the item is ready in the market. These people are going to activity item, presenting it to the judges. So the basic intention of science fairs or any clubs is to inculcate that sense,
right?
Scientific attitude, scientific approach. There absolutely nothing. There will be 1 week in the year when it is done in February 28th, the National Science Day,
yeah,
or some other day. That 1 week they talk about only the activity.
Mm-hmm.
8th day they leave it. They throw off the material somewhere. I didn't like, because it's just like a, you know, routine activity. I'm bored up with that, and
right,
we start, because children are learning nothing.
Cool.
Nothing they are learning. And that's the problem in India. Why don't we have a scientific approach in that? Right from childhood, we are dependent on someone.
Right.
including the vaccine against corona, we are waiting. No, this is not we expect.
Right.
Our vision should be the country should produce indigenous products. The world should depend on us. To do that, we need to do from the childhood.
Right.
So that way, we are trying to trigger out the thoughts and different things. So this Idea Club, what it does is this may be a solution for this.
Okay.
Because every day you are doing an activity. Every day you are doing one activity or forgetting. So my idea is, for me, the inspiration for this is Manipal Institute. So other thing I forgot to tell you, we do a program called as Outreach Learning Program.
Oh, okay.
Where these club people will go to different areas.
Okay.
We'll show them a good university, an IIT, or a good medical college, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, HAL, Bangalore, ISRO. So we take them to leading institutes in India, particularly in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra. In Manipal Institute of Technology in Manipal, last year I took children there. There I was shocked. There is an innovation center in the engineering college.
Okay.
There are workshops, 30 workshops where 30 different projects are being done. One of my students is in a club called Mr. Anand. He started a club called Laksha.
Okay.
The seed, which we also, it has grown to that extent. He has got 2 lakh followers across the globe.
Okay.
He's running an agri club.
Okay.
So I must appreciate Anand that way. So he took me there. No, sir, you must see, we'll let some. He showed everything. There, I am very much impressed by one particular thing. There will be a workshop. The children, the students will be doing projects for 4 years.
Wow.
First year, second year, third year, fourth year, they will be inactive.
Uh-huh.
They do only one project, all of us, and that's a club. They develop a lot of proficiency in that particular club. Suppose, like, I have seen a project called F1 car. they were designing F1 car.
Okay.
So when we were there, they had developed third generation F1 car in the campus.
Wow.
Mechanical engineering student. So I'm impressed with that and I want to implement in the school. This year we are starting where from 6th to 9th, we give chance children to select the ideas. We ask the children to present ideas first.
Right.
We don't give any ideas.
Right.
It's very wild. Right. Any child, every second Saturday, there will be an open forum in the conference hall. Anyone can come and present the idea, whatever area it is, whether good or bad, whatever. Then we will finalize good ideas. And those ideas which are selected, that will be circulated. Mm-hmm. The people who are interested in that particular area, they will make a club. That is an idea club. So several such idea clubs will be. And for each club, idea club, there will be a mentor, one in charge teacher. So he will be working on that particular idea. And a student who joins in 6th class, he will be working on the same till 9th class.
Okay.
Where they can get into some depth. They can learn really something. They know how to do. Because in this course, first of all, they learn their flaws.
Right.
They learn their mistakes. They in trial and error method.
Okay.
They develop thinking.
Correct.
They develop the upper methodology.
Right.
They develop discretion. What is right and what is wrong.
Right.
And they appreciate it.
Right.
And this is a self-inspiring one, self-motivational one, because your yesterday's work is more inspirational for today's work, and today's work will be for the tomorrow's work. So this is an idea club. So these are the important things.
Right. Really good knowing such insightful ideas that's been executed. And inculcating such ideas, making your students getting integrated with hands-on experience. This is really a marvelous thing. I mean, I wish you all the best. And because we all are looking for futuristic, the day should come that we shouldn't depend on any other nations. That's what our Prime Minister is looking forward for from us. So as educators, you are doing your best. Hats off to you, sir. So coming to this, now here comes the biggest challenge. You already have been through many initiatives, but here comes our biggest challenge, the pandemic hit. And the first hit is our educational domain and teachers especially. So talk about how you can handle the morals of your employees and students. How are you handling them?
Very frankly, I tell you, I'm not at all happy with what I'm able to do in this pandemic because everything is limited.
Right.
Everything is limited because everything is under control.
Right.
We have freedom to even at least 20% to do whatever. Your finances will stop.
Right.
First of all.
Okay. I understand.
Learning will stop. So we, once it started in March 18th, our challenge was to conduct exam.
Okay, right.
That was, because end of the academic year, generally annual exam happens.
Right.
Somehow we have done it on
online basis.
It was not even online, I can tell. So we circulated the question paper. We left the children with a message.
You have come up with.
I told them, it's not a test for your subject. It tests to check your integrity.
Right.
Whether you want to copy it, copy, otherwise don't. Most of them did on their own. So certain, if you tell them, they don't do it.
Right.
So that is one thing. The other things, coming to the challenges in learning procedure during the pandemic, one thing is if someone wants to learn six subjects, No need to go anywhere. You have hundreds of online stuff,
right.
Hundreds of sites which can do innumerable amount of stuff. There are fantastic explanations, audio visuals. But what actually happens in school is, school gives the warmth the child need at that particular age.
Correct.
School, going to school is mandatory.
Yes.
Right? So that has become a big problem, and we started online as a way through Zoom. I was closely watching for 2 weeks. Teacher is teaching at home, having a mobile at one corner, board here. He can't see. The problem in this is you can't see many people. You can see only two or three, that too from a distance.
The classroom.
So teacher observing students is totally ruled out, which is very important. As far as schooling is concerned, the affection and warmth,
right,
is shared through eye contact. More communication is done through eye contact.
Correct.
30 eyes will be focusing on one pair of eyes at the board, that is teacher. And this one pair of eyes will be controlling all the 30 students in the room. That is the beautiful relation between a teacher and student. With one pair of eyes, he comes up there. He communicates his love. He communicates his warmth.
Right.
Thereby nurtures the human relations. Indirectly influences the child. A child, right, has to be influenced by the teacher.
Correct.
That was the major problem.
Right.
Second thing, always, are you a studious student or a naughty student? So that when you were in school.
Me, I'm studious, sir.
What?
I'm very honest. I'm very studious.
See,
naughty as well.
Seriously?
I enjoyed,
okay,
my childhood, school, okay, school days. Completely.
But most of the kids are very naughty. You know what they do is, they'll also log in for attendance sake. They switch on the videos, go to kitchen, they play somewhere else. So our main objective of conducting online in the pandemic is not to break the learning procedure.
Correct.
For any matter, if it is broken at one point of time and it is taking 5 to 6 months, to bring the child to the learning environment, it takes 2 to 3 months again. So I don't want it to do it. So for 2 weeks, I observed, I made sure that no child is listening to the lesson. And there is a drop in teaching levels of the teachers also, because they don't have any motive. Right?
Correct.
They don't have any motive.
Right.
So then we thought of interactive sessions. So I called all the teachers to school. I gave one room to each school. We projected all the students on the wall.
Okay.
Because even laptop also, we cannot see the children. Because
correct.
So every child is displayed on the wall. On the other end, the teacher will be teaching on the blackboard.
Okay.
There will be one moderator to take care of the issues.
Right.
Now, as if the teacher felt very comfortable and very confident and very interesting.
Okay.
And teachers started coming in formals and all. Oh. At home, it's... So it influences.
Right. At home, it's a neutral environment. You don't have stimulation.
Yeah. Every meeting I used to tell them, I'll have to tell them. So we're coming formal. So they don't have drive. They don't have drive and motive. They can. So everything got into a serious track after 1 week. So I used to log in, and my vice principals, they also used to log in the middle of the class. So everyone is visible. My teachers will ask the questions. Because there is a rule, at least 5 to 6 students need to ask questions.
Right.
So that's how the classes were made very, very interesting, interactive. And even they are departed so many kilometers, they can have eye contact with one another. So I don't say this is the solution, but what all we can do, what best can be done in this pandemic time, you have done it that way. And that's why our attendance is more when compared to the other things. Okay. And parents are also happy that children are sitting in a room seriously for about 3 hours.
Made a successful attempt with your remote teaching methodologies. I mean, projecting students on a bigger screens.
But I have a regret. I mean, we cannot, no one can replace the actual classroom scenario. Right. So, and we also, you know, sometimes at times we become low because we are used to children, hundreds of children. Every day we have to see hundreds of children.
Right. You've been habituated all your life, all these years.
Yeah, really missing all the
children. Chaos, the school, the sounds of the school, the bell and everything, I guess you'll be missing.
So that's about teaching, and we are using Google Sheets for examination.
Okay.
Yeah, doing well. Parents are also happy to a certain extent. So that's what we could do. And coming to the morale of the staff. Most unfortunately, this is the industry where the people are paid very less.
I know.
We have 150 staff, out of which 60 are teachers, 50. Remaining all are supporting staff. We are taking care of all the 150 for the last 5 months. And because we need to stand with the people.
Right, right.
In the tough times.
Correct.
So we cut off all other expenditure. So we are giving them salaries, and for the OYAs and some fourth class employees for 1 or 2 months, we even supplied grocery also.
Okay.
So they're also within our financial scope.
Right. Absolutely.
Done it, and we talk to them. We call them to school because no one is working in the school.
Right.
We call them at times for meetings and all. We share the ideas.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm happy with what we have done in the pandemic as far as my staff are concerned. Because today we are in this position in Anantapur district as a school. That's just because of the team. As a leader, you may have hundreds and hundreds of thought. In teaching, that doesn't work. You need to have a right team. I have the best team. We have the best team, right? So we are with them and we will be with them. So
kudos to your spirit, sir. Kudos to being standing even in the challenging periods with your teachers. As you say, they are the brand ambassadors of your school.
Certainly.
They are your face of your school.
Certainly. No problem, so that everything will come back.
True. That's the
somewhere or the other.
We'll find out. Right, so there are a few misconceptions and statements associated with teaching and educators. Would you love to prove them wrong or true or false? I have a few statements.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
There are people, like we have very popular icons, Mark Zuckerberg, then we have someone like Bill Gates, who are college and school dropouts. There are many like that. So do you think these people who are school and college dropouts are lucky? They didn't go through schooling?
Not
but they made it.
Not at all.
Okay.
Can you count on such people? I think the total population is of world is 700 crores.
Right.
You stop work with only three names. Okay. So drop. They are now successful people not because they are dropouts.
Right, absolutely.
They are potential, self-driven. I can say self-driven.
Yes, sir.
So whether they were in colleges or not, wherever they were, for sure they will be in this position.
Right.
Okay. It doesn't matter where they are. So they are exceptional. They are exceptional.
Probably they might have worked double than the college goers.
For sure.
Position today that we have been idolizing them.
But only regret is they miss the college.
Oh yeah, sure. I guess they surely will be having that. As we are missing our schools, likewise they might be missing. So another one here. Teaching is an easy job. It's all about repeating over and over again the same things. How true is this?
It is easier for the people who make it easy by tough preparation.
Okay.
Every year I need to prepare. Otherwise, you're lost.
Okay.
If you believe that repetition and repetition works, you will last. You may be a mere teacher. Yeah. You can't be an inspirer. You cannot ignite anything students.
Which we might remain as a mediocre or stereotypical teaching.
And student will make them out very easy. Right.
Here comes another one. Good teaching has always known by different strokes for different folks, like different learning methodologies. You should keep bringing new learning styles. How true is this, sir? Only a good teacher can do that. New learning styles.
Definitely. 100% I accept with this, because you are not dealing with any machine.
Right.
So this is my AC remote. All over the world, it has got a single manual. A layman can do it. Right. A teacher can do it. A professor. They will have to do only this thing. On and off, one power button is only one for everyone. Right. So an engineer is the luckiest person in the world. You design a product, check it, leave it. The toughest job is teachers, because every child is a machine.
Okay.
Different machine.
Right.
And not a uniform machine. Every day he changes. Every period he changes.
Oh, his moods, health, psychological conditions.
Teacher has to do case study of each and every child, morning, afternoon, evening, and they'll have to understand child completely, take some feedback from the parents.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, we'll have our PTA meetings. Then we need to work according to each. Learning is common.
Okay.
Learning is common.
That's cool.
But teaching life is specific. You need to teach life specific to the every student.
Right.
So what it all is like.
So finally, you have proved it right. So learning styles have to be brought to each child. It evolves, it changes, transforms.
Yeah. As far as subject learning is concerned, so that there should be a common mode. Or this.
Okay.
20% we need to change according to the child.
Okay.
Because where they may be lagging, and we need to help them personally, individually.
Right.
So they definitely need personal care.
Wonderful knowing so many ideologies and your beliefs, sir, and good job. That the best part is that you're standing with your team. I am really overwhelmed to know that. Hope our viewers are also happy to see you speak about your initiatives, about your school, your career. But here comes our most interesting segment, rapid question round. So are you ready for it?
We'll try.
Okay. So how is a typical day of Solomon, sir?
For teachers, it will be very routine. For any sir, it is a routine.
Right.
But,
how is life now?
Every time, because I believe in happiness, Sudha.
Right.
Live happily, let others live happily. If you can't make others happy, right, never hurt any. That's my philosophy. So, every morning starts with walking. Then there itself will check hostel students.
Okay.
Then the teachers or the management's advantage is you will have a big ground there. You can complete your morning walk,
right,
and you can talk to the children in the morning hours and come back. After that, school starts at 8:30. You attend prayer. And I do go for rounds at least thrice or four times a day.
Right.
I never enter into any classroom so as not to distract the teacher. While taking teacher into the job, itself, I'll make sure that I'm taking good teacher.
Okay.
I don't check them in person because there will be influence always. So
right.
I don't believe in that.
Right.
If any flaws are there, we'll get to know through the children. Then we can correct it. So then again, evening I play a couple of, I know, at every game I spend a couple of minutes.
Okay.
Basketball I play for 5 minutes just for interaction with the children.
Uh-huh. Okay.
There they'll come to you. Whole day it will be a serious affair.
Okay. So
every day we have 1 hour of games period. All the children will be in the ground. So I'll go to every game. I talk to them. I touch them because a touch of teacher is very important for the student. I believe that. That's how we'll complete the day. Come back, fresh up. Then again go to study hours.
Okay.
So end day by
cycle.
Yeah. End day by 9:30.
Right.
By the time you forget, again your second day will start. You cannot come out of school.
That's what, right.
But now pandemic, we are missing a lot. Missing.
I know.
Yeah.
So do you teach?
No, not. But I go to classes and talk to them.
Okay.
I talk to them because children likes me a lot.
Okay.
So I tell them. I talk about general issues.
Okay.
How to be, how not to be.
Right.
So, teaching, I don't teach because I taught at a higher level. That is the problem I told you.
Right.
So I taught at a higher level and I cannot teach.
Right.
I may not justify my job. Moreover, visitors and all, right. I'm the correspondent and principal. That's the problem.
Oh, okay.
So I'll have to take care of everything. That one I'm deadly missing.
Okay.
Right.
So if you aren't you choose career into teaching, you know, you choose or that teaching choose you, whatever, destiny choose you. But if you aren't into teaching, what would you be?
Actually, I never had a thought of becoming anything.
Okay.
My parents wanted me to become a doctor.
Okay.
We overacted in intermediate and couldn't become a dad. So then it was like, you know,
okay.
There was no vision, nothing like that. It just happened.
Just happened.
I realized I came into this thing. Then while doing my projects, promotions, I sit with the designer. I design my own posters and all.
Okay.
Then I realized because I never sat 1 hour on book.
Okay.
To be frank. When we were in designing, continuously I sat for more than 6 to 7 hours. I liked it very much. So given a chance, I want to be a designer. Whatever designer it is, a creative designer. I like it. I love it.
Right. You're designing students' lives right now. What more do we want?
Thank you.
The one person or any incident that you still remember is inspirational for you? Any short incident or a person?
It's not like that. As I told you, the incident I tell you.
Yeah.
The incident is me becoming a government teacher.
A government teacher, okay. That was a life-changing.
It relates me to look at where I actually am.
Okay.
I realized how people started treating me. Because
okay.
Everyone has become doctors and engineer by then. Some people went, you know, even US also by then.
Okay.
But then that was the most, you know, teasing part of life at the
okay.
same time. From there I brought up the inspiration.
Okay.
On my own.
You stood tall.
And people also, not one or I can't mention one particular person. I learned from all odds.
Okay.
I learned from all faults.
Right.
So there are a couple of people, I can't mention their names.
Okay.
They ignited fire in me.
Okay. So that's the reason why you are today.
I may not be in talking terms with them today.
Okay.
I personally thank them. They know who they are.
Okay, so someone watching us, I guess.
Thank you, Sudha.
You gave me some cues are hitting them.
So, thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity, right?
Right.
So, those people, right. Generally, you know, I'm a very close watcher of everyone.
Okay.
I observe each and every person. I get inspired every day from everyone. I mean, like, at times I get inspired by small kids. So that's how it happened. Not particularly someone. Right?
So everything to anything inspires you. You just be vigilant and observant, I guess.
That's
what you have in you.
Yeah, I'll put it in the right way.
That's your innate quality, I guess.
Thank you.
So one belief you always advocate for teachers, as a teacher. One belief, what is your one belief?
Love your students.
Okay.
Everything will fall in line.
Nothing more than loving your students.
But it's very difficult.
How come?
No. Most of the people don't do that. That's why the lives of the kids are becoming miserable and miserable.
Sure.
Most of the people doesn't even know what is love. You need to understand the child. You need to understand the child by looking at his face. If you really love.
Right.
I tell them, always I believe in them. You love the children.
Right.
Whether you give good facilities or not, whether you give good teachers or not, that doesn't matter. Your love will communicate everything and transfer the knowledge. And on top of it, the love which we are sharing will shape the humanitarian angle in the students. That's what I get.
Wonderful belief system, sir. Awesome. One book that you love and recommend? Any one book?
Actually, all the questions were very, very, you know, interesting and comfortable.
I get that. I can see on your face about reading.
I am a bad reader.
Okay, let me push this off and...
No, but let me complete. I read only one book. A couple of books. My Experiments with Truth.
Uh-huh, I'm kidding.
And Wings of Fire.
Right.
Chetan Bhagat's two books I read while I was on bench.
Okay.
Two States is one. The other one is...
My Mistakes of My Life.
So, of all this, I like Wings of Fire. And I recommend everyone.
Okay.
Because it really talks to you. It makes you realize that every individual has got a potential.
Right.
So it's a wonderful book. Need not read hundreds of books. Such book is enough.
The concept is very conversational. When you read, you feel he's talking to us.
Yes.
I can connect to
Yeah.
So, one skill that you learned in lockdown. What did lockdown taught you?
Nothing.
Nothing.
I enjoy music, so I listen to the music. One of the skills. Because generally, the general answer for this question I am hearing nowadays is cooking.
Yes.
But I don't like kitchen.
Also, videos are viral right now. Cooking viral. Cooking.
So, I know most of the gents, men, they learn cooking. Most of my friends, they started cooking, helping their wives and all.
So, are you also?
I pity my wife. I never get into kitchen.
She couldn't teach you. Right. So any tips to aspiring new age educators, apart from loving children, what would you say that those who think that, okay, it's easy job to get our teaching job and let's get into it.
So, yeah, it's a good question. In fact, as a teacher, we are dealing with next gen kids. So you are producing a product after a decade or so.
Right.
Your vision has to go to that level.
Absolutely.
What would be the social demand? What would be the market demand? By understanding, so you need to have that vision first. It's very, very difficult.
Right.
And come back to the present day situation. Go back to what he has learned. Connect these three. Help him to go to that level. So teacher has to work a lot.
True.
And on top of it, every child has got a different interest. Everything a teacher has.
Right.
So all teachers, I request you, just think about future. How science and technology is going to be, how politics are going to be, how things around the world are going to be. Try to analyze on your own, because you cannot dream. Take the content now, what all data readily available, and project it for 10 years. Anyone can do it. And you tell the students same thing. There, you're showing the path.
Right.
Don't dump, no. KBs and GBs of information into the mind. They'll know how to learn. Show them path, they'll know.
Right. So you want the new age educators to be pathfinders for the upcoming generations, I guess.
That's what. If you don't have a vision, we cannot drive anyone.
True.
Because, as I told earlier, it's a repetitive challenge.
Right.
One will get bored of. To keep yourself afresh, you need to know more and more knowledge, work on it more and more,
right.
Include it in your teachings. Your teaching will be bettered. You also feel very happy. For every new class, you need to be very, very happy.
Right.
And this will happen only when you love learning.
Right, passion-driven working.
Yeah.
So upgrading oneself is very important for teachers, I guess. Every generation.
Sure.
So wonderful knowing you've been nailed all the questions or the rapid questions. I really enjoyed all your answers. Our viewers are definitely going to know so much more with this particular question. One rhetorical question, I guess, will make you more enhancing, and here it goes. What if you are stranded in an island? How do you see the situation? There's no one around to rescue you. You better show all the Kodaganhalli survival skills, school skills.
I'll give you a rather serious answer for this.
Okay, yes.
Maybe you're expecting a different one. I love God. I believe in God. I love God.
Okay.
If really I get a chance of that kind, I'll pray God till I get a chance to talk to him. Thereafter, you can get out of the island. It's not a
okay. So God, the Almighty, is your only survival, I guess.
Immediately after seeing that question, it struck my mind. So I don't want to change the answer. So.
Awesome, sir. Any suggestions on pep talk? How did you like it?
Good, Sudha. Let me go through another episodes also. Continuously, I'll be following now. It's really good. It's a new experience for me, and really great, because many people will come to know because there are failure stories. There are success stories. One individual will have failure and success story. It's called an integrated story.
Right.
And you're sharing it to many thousands of people and keeping it in air so that many can see in future also. It's really wonderful. No suggestions. At a very early age, you are doing such a wonderful work. I must appreciate, right? You convey my wishes to parents for having such a wonderful daughter.
Oh, thank you.
Don't forget.
I want to thank Suresh Perbu sir also for introducing you to us.
Me too.
Yes. Because on just a word he mentioned me, why don't you call Solomon sir? He is doing a tremendous work. So he has read my intention and he has referred you. I should thank you, thank Suresh sir.
Thank you. So I tried my level best to come in. This is
no, first. You did your best, sir. Not just level best. You are awesome. You rock. No,
this is my first talk, interactive talk. Right. Anyway, so I was doubtful whether I could justify or not, and you'll have to tell me. Thank you very much for giving this chance, and I thank all my Suresh Anna for referring my name. It's a pandemic gift. Yeah. I can. And on this occasion, on this screen, I sincerely extend my gratitude to Almighty God for helping me, driving me here, and my parents, and in particular my wife, who is also an academician with me, and my family, and of course my friends, and finally, last but not least, the people who smiled at you when you were down.
Beautiful. That's a wonderful sign-off message to all our viewers for this pandemic. Thank you very much, sir, for joining Pep Talk. Bye-bye, sir.
Thank you so much. Bye.
So back to you all again. Yes, that was Solomon Roth. So all the way from Anandpur district, he spoke length and breadth about what's all about teaching and how a teacher should evolve with the new normal life that we are going to be facing and that we are facing, and how students have to be nurtured, not just being taught, but to be nurtured into a wonderful individuals so that we can give them back to the society. Well, that's all for today. I'll be back again with yet another interesting Pep Talk session with yet another amazing academician sharing his or her insights of their journey with teaching. Till then, keep smiling, and I'll be back again. Bye-bye.